Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. So if you are first time in this channel, please click subscribe. Please click also bell icon so that you will be notified if there is new video in this channel. And please click also like and share. So in my previous video, I discussed there that how to calculate fuel oil consumption for the ship engines without flowmeter. But this time, I'm going to teach you how to calculate the fuel oil consumption for ship's engine with flowmeter. So now we have here the problem, how to calculate the consumption of fuel oil. So we have here the given data, specific gravity of fuel at 15, 0.9850, fuel oil service tank temperature, degrees Celsius, 90, flowmeter reading, so for example, December 1 or 1 December 2019 at 1200 hours, because this is noon to noon reporting. So this is also applicable for this calculation is applicable also for in of sea passage, start of sea passage, departure from port, arrival in port, finish engine, known at anchor, known to known. So this because you have flowmeter, you can easily monitor the consumption. So here flowmeter reading at 2 December 2019 at 1200 hours, so in liters, is 1849650, and the previous is 1830320, and we have here the correction factor, so it's either 0.00067 or 0.00065. So it depends on the fuel oil specification. So let us proceed here. Consumption in cubic meter. So you have to write the flowmeter in present reading and flowmeter in previous reading, divided by 1000. So this is in liters, as you can see here, liters, and you divide in 1000 liters, because 1 cubic meter is equal to 1000 liters. So this is, I will give you the conversion. So 1 cubic meter, 1 cubic meter is equal to 1000 liters. So that is the conversion. So that is the conversion. So now let us proceed. So you have to write. So as you can see here, I bring down this beta here. I substitute. So present reading, this one, and previous reading, this one. So I write here, and divide by 1000. So minus this one. So as you can see, I minus this one, the previous reading, the present reading minus the previous reading. So this will give you 19330. So that one, and divide by 1000. So if you divide 19330 divided by 1000, so as you can see, so I divide this one, so this will give you the result of 19 decimal 33 cubic meter. So you have now the consumption in cubic meter. So as per reading of the present flow meter and the previous flow meter. So we have to calculate the corrected specific gravity. So some chief engineers, if the what we call if the adjust the consumption, so they will just adjust the temperature, because by adjusting the temperature of the fuel oil in the service tank, you can change the consumption of the engine. So now corrected specific gravity at 15. So this is the formula. Corrected specific gravity at 15 minus temperature 2 minus temperature 1 times or multiplied by coefficient factor. So now let us see. So first you have to rewrite bring down the value here. So this is your specific gravity at 15. So this one, so substitute the value. So now, so you substitute also the value of T2, which is this one, temperature 2, which is the fuel oil service tank temperature, and you substitute the value of T1, which is constant. So this is constant multiplier when you are taking corrected specific gravity of your fuel oil. So this is constant because at 15. So you substitute and multiply it by your correction factor. So now we will be using 0.00067. So it depends on the what we call the specification of the fuel oil. So now you have to rewrite again your specific gravity here. Then you have to subtract first the temperature 2 minus temperature 1. So 90 minus 15 is equal to 75, as you can see. So I minus this one, I subtract, then this will give you 75, and then multiplied by our coefficient factor. So here, so your temperature difference. So this is already a temperature difference. So I will write here. Temperature difference. So this is temperature difference. So that is temperature difference. So your temperature difference, you have to multiply it by your coefficient factor, which is 0.00067. Then this is the result, as you can see. 75 this multiplied by the correction factor 0.00067, this will give you 0.05, and then rewrite the specific gravity at 15, and then you have to minus. So now, as you can see, I subtract 0.9850 minus 0.05, and you get this corrected specific gravity, which is 0.9348, this one. So now we have to calculate the consumption in metric tons, because here our consumption here is in volume, in cubic meter. Now let us calculate in metric tons, because when you are reporting to your company, if you are a chief engineer, you have to report in metric tons. So consumption in metric tons, corrected specific gravity multiplied by consumption in cubic meter. So consumption in consumption in metric tons is equal to corrected specific gravity multiplied by consumption in cubic meter. So we will substitute the value. So as you can see here, I substitute this value here, and I substitute also the cubic meter value here to here. So if you multiply that one, so you can see, I multiply this one, 0.9348 multiplied by 19.33 cubic meter. This will give you in metric tons, which is weight. This is weight. Metric tons is weight and cubic meter is volume. So this will give you 18.07 metric tons. So this is your consumption. So this calculation, since you have a flow meter, these are all applicable on this is all applicable for non consumption, end of sea passage consumption, start of sea passage consumption, finish with engine consumption, departure consumption, consumption in port, and consumption at anchor. Because you have flow meter, you can easily monitor the fuel oil consumption. So I hope you learned something in this tutorial, in this video discussion. So for those who are aspiring to become a chief engineer, you should learn engine room mathematics, because whether you like it or not, if you become chief engineer, you have to calculate all the fuel oil and lube oil as well as press water. You have to calculate and you have to report to the company, especially if there is a charter. If the company is chartered by other company, meaning your ship is being hired by other company, you have a lot of calculation. So just like Japanese company, Korean company, so even the third engineer is doing the calculation, the abstract, so the reporting, and then the chief engineer is only checking and signing the report. So but especially if you're chief engineer, you should know how to calculate fuel consumption. It's very important. So nowadays nobody teaching in school. Since I am teaching in school almost 3 years, then there is no topic in reporting, visual reporting in the school. There is no topic, so you only learn when you are marine engineer. So since now I am creating videos, then I recommend aspiring chief engineers. So even cadets, ratings, engine ratings, junior engineers, second engineers, and even those who are aspiring chief engineer, it is very important to study engine room mathematics, because whether you like it or not, when you become chief engineer, you will encounter this calculation. So I have a lot of calculation in this YouTube channel, but it is not yet complete, but I am planning to do more video tutorial to help those aspiring to become a marine engineer, and especially chief engineer. So I hope you learned something in this video. Thank you for watching, and see you on my next video tutorial.